Hi guys, welcome to this channel, and in today's video I will explain you step by step how to apply for Erasmus Mundus scholarship. This is the scholarship which I talk about in this video, so if you don't know what is it, check it out. And I'm currently doing my third semester in Lund University in Sweden. So why you should listen to me? Because I got a scholarship and I was accepted to 3 programs out of 3. What is really good for you? There is no age limit. So doesn't matter if you're 24 or 54, you can do the Erasmus Mundus Master. Careful, you're not eligible to get the scholarship if you already have some master diploma. Also, you don't need to have a work experience, you can have it, and it's benefit to have it in your CV, at least some internship, but it's not required. And also, if you're not the best student in the world, you can apply, because if I could have done that, believe me, you can do it too. I never had amazing grades. I would say I had pretty diverse experience in my portfolio, but that's it. So the criteria to be accepted are composed of all those requirements. You need to collect all those materials and submit all of them. It might seem very overwhelming, and I admit, but believe me, if you follow this guide step by step, then you will have no problem to be accepted and without stress. You're asking, why my university is not telling me about this, and why not this professor told me about this? They knew I want to travel. Well, I would say it's because universities want that you study at their universities, that you continue at their master program, and they don't want you voluntarily sent you somewhere else. I would say that's the thing, and therefore there is difficult to just reach out one single professor which would answer all your questions to Erasmus Mundus programs, and usually you need to contact some advisors from the program, or you can reach to some previous students who have been admitted to Erasmus Mundus program, like me for example. Step number one, make yourself familiar with the requirements. Check out the catalog. The link to catalog is down here, and see what is required from you from specific programs. There will be specifications for the English proficiency test, like IELTS or Cambridge or TOEFL. Make yourself familiar with the requirements for the academic entry. Usually we are just talking about master programs, but what previous background is needed. Also check out what you need to do to apply. Like, do you really want to spend time writing the motivational letter and getting the letter of recommendations from your professors, just to get more familiar what is expected from you, and so you're not so surprised after. You can also check up the scholarship criteria, what it's covered in your program, but usually the programs should cover the most necessary expenses, and if you know how to, you can also save up some money from this scholarship too, just for fun. Tip number two. Okay, so you went through the requirements, now it's time to decide for which programs you want to go for. I would say this is the exciting part, where you're choosing between the countries and between the programs. So this is funny, but be careful, don't choose more than 3 programs. You're not allowed to apply for more than 3 programs. I suggest to choose one program which is very probable that you will be accepted, and then maybe one or two which are more like a dream. Anyway, you should consider what is your hobby, what is your passion, and somehow what is your background. As I mentioned, not for all programs the background is needed, some specific background is needed. Like for my program, I studied tourism and culture development, and many of my colleagues have completely different background, from archaeology, international relations, or business administration. Tip number three is to check out the deadlines. As I mentioned, every 1st October new programs are offered. So if you check it out in October or mid-October, end of October, you're totally fine. My application took me around a month and a half, but I was very precise. I know people who made the application within a week. But check out the deadlines as soon as possible, because believe me, it will take you some time to get the recommendation letters from your professors, because they have some other work to do than just write your recommendation letter. Check out also the dates for your language test, because maybe you don't have this Cambridge C1, you have maybe B2, but this is not enough. So check out the dates, the possible dates where you can make the language course. Scholarship deadlines are usually in mid-January, maybe at the end of January, but don't worry, if you don't want to apply for the, or if you don't have enough time and you just figure out about this amazing program a little later, you can still apply as self-funded student, I guess by the end of May or by the end of June, actually. So there is never too late. But at least to try to apply for the scholarship is really nice, because even if you don't get the scholarship, you can be still accepted and you can know about your exception already in in May or in March, which is nice, and you don't have to wait till the summer. You can just enjoy summer and say, I was already accepted. Informal notification about your acceptance and on selection, it's usually in March, it's mid till the end of March, which you will get in official, unofficial email from the university that you've been selected for the scholarship and also admitted for the program. And this is the time where you can start thinking, okay, do I want to accept this program or do I want to decline? You will have to do it. Even if you don't want to, you should decline it. I was accepted for all three programs and I had to decline those two, said thank you because you didn't give me scholarship, so I don't want to study at your institution. No, just joking, but it was definitely nice to get the scholarship, so I went for the one where I got the scholarship. Official decision on master's accepted students is usually released in the mid or till the end of May, approximately. And then the deadline for completing enrollment documentation, this might happen if you didn't have time to make the language test, is till the 30th of June, approximately. Again, this is just a very rough schedule and you need to check out the specific program. By the 1st of July, you should already know if you're accepted, under what conditions, if unconditionally or conditionally, because you can be actually accepted conditionally, which means you still need to submit this or that or that. The fact that you're accepted doesn't mean that, hey, I'm done with it. Step number 4, create a time schedule and also make a winner mindset. Start early so you won't be panicking when the deadlines approach, because believe me, it takes time. As I mentioned, it takes time. And I would also recommend make some dream board or vision board, like print out those pictures and say, in 1 year I will be studying there and I will be student of this university, because I was telling this all the time and I kind of believe it helped. I'm not saying this is the only reason why I was accepted, but you know, I was always saying like, I am accepted in 2019. I was always repeating this to myself. So just make the schedule and the mindset. Also, make a checklist. This is very nice. Just make, for this week, I wanna finish the first draft of this paper, and by this date, I wanna get to recommendation letters and so on. Tip number 5. This one is pretty obvious and it's work on it. Work, 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 work. Write perfect motivation letter. That can take up to several weeks. Why? Because you rewrite it, you send it to your friend, then you send it to second friend, then you send it to professor, and they say no, this not, and this yes, and this not. And if you're applying for more program than one, then you have to do it 3 times, at least this motivation letter. I'm not saying you have to write it completely from scratch, but you need to adjust it a little bit, you know. I'm applying to this program because this one is the best because of those subjects. And then you need to always tailor it to the program you will be sending the application to. Luckily, your portfolio or your curriculum vitae doesn't vary so much, but believe me, the motivation letter was for me quite difficult, and especially because it was, I think, up to 3 pages for one program. So yeah, it takes ages. It takes ages. What I needed to collect for my application, I actually ordered the items in my computer, and it was CV, university degree, transcript of record, means grade in my bachelor, motivational letter, language certificate, letters of recommendations, and passport. If you're applying for the scholarship, of course, you need to also fill in the scholarship form. This doesn't take so much time, but you just need to do it properly, and these applications might be accessed on their websites. As I mentioned, and I need to stress it one more time, it's so important to put a lot of effort into your motivational letter, because maybe you don't influence your grades anymore because you're done with bachelor, but the thing that you can really influence is the motivational letter, stating properly the reasons why you want to study this program, what can you gain from this program, what can the university gain from accepting you. Because some programs put more than 40% emphasis and value to your motivational letter and your portfolio. So it's really not just, oh, this one has good grades, give him a scholarship. It's really about like everything. Everything just needs to go together. Point number 6 is finish all the materials, check and upload. Check specifically what you have to upload, where you have to upload it, because it can again be a little bit different, something you send in PDF, something in online form. So check this properly and upload it. Point number 7 is to wait. This might be a little bit frustrating, because if you submit early, then you're waiting a lot. But if you maybe you're interested, if you're waiting, you're interested like how your application will be accessed. This again, it's very individual, but I can assure you that application will be considered solely on the basis of your academic merits, abilities and potential, regardless of gender, ethnic or nation, origin, age, disability, religion, sexual orientation or any irrelevant distinction. And yeah, so I think this might be also helpful. And while you're waiting and you're non-European, try to check out try to see the process of visa, because this can take a lot of time from what I've heard. So just use this waiting time usefully. Tip number 8, connect with other applicants. You can search on Google, on Reddit, on Facebook. I'm sure you will find someone, or create a group on Facebook and you will see that eventually there will be more people coming in, and connect with them, talk about them, discuss with them, but just don't, I would say again, don't discuss too much, because you cannot change your application anyway. But it's really nice to already networking a little bit with your future colleagues. And then the final point is receiving the decision from the university, and I really, really hope it's positive for you. And then there is the dilemma, decline or accept, decline or accept, because eventually you can study only one program and you have to decline some if you applied for two and you were accepted to both. But even if you're not accepted, there are still options. You can apply next year, or you can make the university and consortium revise your application if maybe they made some mistake, or maybe you are on the waiting list. I know a lot of students who were not accepted and once, and they applied next year, or they applied the third year. Well, like, why not? There is really never too late to apply for Erasmus Mundus. Guys, I hope this video was interesting for you. You learned something new. If still there are some hesitation about what is Erasmus Mundus, check out the video. And I wish you a lot of success. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe it, and write me in the comment in which program are you interested. And if you think that this video can be helpful for someone who wants to travel, who wants to study abroad, live abroad, and who can try to apply for the scholarship, amazing scholarship in Europe and around the world, send them this video so they are also informed and they don't miss out this amazing opportunity, which is actually really for everyone. Thank you for watching, and see you in next video.